Saturday night?
Disappointment. You know, hurts to lose, and hurts to lose. You know, twice in the season. So, yeah, disappointment, sadness. Went home and you know, hugged my people and got up the next day and kept fighting on.
Now, you know, your goal has always been to win a national title. There's been no two-loss national champion.
Yeah.
How do you kind of move forward after that disappointment?
Yeah, you don't. I mean, we're halfway through the season and you don't necessarily know what's going to happen. I mean, you've seen a lot of ranked teams lose. You've seen a lot of close games with ranked teams. And right now, there's a lot of one-loss teams and, you know, not so many, you know, winless or lossless teams. And so, you know, you keep going, you keep fighting. You stay out here, extra time, be with your guys, because you never know when the opportunity is going to come. When the opportunity comes, you want to be able to, you know, seize that opportunity. And so, you know, we're going to keep going, keep fighting on, and, you know, keep trying to reach our goals.
How do you keep your...
personally deal with adversity, back-to-back losses on the season? How do you personally deal with adversity?
Yeah, just like I said, I go and, you know, love my people. That's first and foremost, is, you know, get around the people that, you know, you've been with your whole life, been training with, or, you know, whatever case may be. So I go, you know, get out of here and kind of just go have a day on Sunday and just, you know, get your mind off of it. That's the most important thing, is kind of get your mind off of it. Obviously, it doesn't fully, you know, your mind doesn't fully remove off of it, but, you know, try and get that portion of it, you know, to a certain sense, and then, you know, get back and ready to go. Get back in on Sunday or Monday morning and get going.
Well, you're still on the bench late in the game, and the team is coming up to you kind of, talking to you. What was going through your mind at the moment?
When
you were sitting on the bench at the end of the game, just kind of by yourself, kind of in your thoughts a little bit?
Yeah, I was just staying calm, you know, believing in defense and honestly just staying calm in that moment. You know, believing that the guys out there were going to go, you know, do the job and you know, stop them and either block the field goal or stop them, whatever the case may be. So that was the main thing of it, was trying to stay calm and not get too riled up. It's one of the biggest things that, you know, you learn from being coached by a guy that doesn't really get too rowdy, is stay calm in those moments. That's the most important thing, whether it's overtime and, you know, you got to go back out in the field, or, you know, it's the end of the game and, you know, you're just trying to stay in a certain mental space, and don't get too wrapped up into the moment.
What kind of communication, like, did you have while he was sick, and maybe how did the first two practices, they feel different or the same with Cliff being a little bit more of a presence?
Yeah, I mean, obviously they feel different. You know, there's a, I mean, from when your head man isn't here, there's obviously a little difference, but I mean, he's built a, you know, the coaches, or whether it's the players and the culture and things like that, there's an understanding of, like, if somebody goes down, it's next man up. And so, even in the head man position, you know, we understood that, you know, he was dealing with stuff. And our communication was still the same. We were calling each other, you know, after practice. We were talking about plays. We were going over stuff, you know, things like that. So, you know, with him not being here, obviously, you know, things did change, because it's, you know, it's hard for things not to change when, say, a player is out, or say when a coach is out, like himself. Things change, obviously, but they didn't change too much just because of what we built. Just because of what we build as a team, as a culture, and everybody still has that one goal and things like that in mind. So, yeah.
Let's do one more.
What did Utah do in the middle of that game to make it tough to score?
Play good defense, and we made a lot of mistakes. I'd say that was the main and biggest thing, is, you know, teams try to keep the ball out of our hands on offense, and, you know, we get our shots, we gotta take advantage of them. That's something we didn't do. You know, we either turned the ball over, we had three and outs, and stalled drives, and a lot of them was because we were playing 10-on-11. You know, at one point, you know, different person, different things like that, including myself. You know, one person messes up and you're playing 10-on-11 at that point. You know, it's hard to win games, hard to go score. Offense and offensive ball is always 11-on-11. So, That being said, you know, they did a good job, and, you know, we got to get better, simply put. Thank you.